spot that I came and scouted. I'm going to stand a couple weeks ago. A lot of big oak trees right here. Hopefully a couple of them are dropping. I had a few of them marked on my map that they had a lot of acorns on them earlier this year, but hopefully we timed it right and they should be dropping, so we'll see what comes through. Get in an awkward position to try to shoot that doe. And when I released my bowstring, clipped my pant leg, and just sent my arrow 7 feet offline. So it's sticking in a tree down there. Man, she came right here. I don't know how well video turn out just because I could not move. I'm not very high up in this tree because this is all the higher I could really go and still keep all this nice back cover, but apparently I was hitting pretty well because she walked right here directly under my platform and never picked me off, so apparently I'm hitting pretty well. But that was pretty awesome. She was right here. That was pretty close. See my lighted knock right there. Well, time to get down and see if I can get that arrow back. This is why they were here. This one's not a ripe one, but there's a bunch of them laying around underneath this big oak tree. After I shot, she was standing right here, and I was right there in that platform, about 12 feet off the ground. But as you can see, some pretty good cover. So that's why I picked the tree I picked. Pretty wide open over here, but over there by my stand is about the only bit of good cover I had to pick from. That doe was standing right here behind this little cherry tree. And here's my arrow. About 4 feet offline. And I do not think I'm getting that broadhead back, unfortunately. But I think the arrow looks like it's okay, so try to unscrew it and see if I can get it back. Alright, came out here today to do a little scouting, hang a stand. I'm back at the spot where I shot a doe a couple weeks ago. Wanted to come back in today and see if any fresh sign had popped up since then. And there are just acorns all over the place. I had a feeling that these bigger oaks would start dropping, like this one here and behind me. And they run all the way up and down this old logging road. And every time the wind picks up, you can hear acorns falling. And the ground is just covered with acorns. And that goes all the way up and down this ridge. A ton of fresh sign. There's probably a dozen piles of deer droppings right here under this big white oak. And you can see all the leaves torn up from the deer, digging around, looking for acorns. I was just starting to get a little bit discouraged, but it all worked out right at the end. I was starting to make a game plan for the afternoon where I wanted to scout and stuff, and saw those does down below me in that draw. I figured they would have smelled me a long time ago. I thought there was no way they'd get all the way up here. That's directly downwind from me. But it worked out. didn't get winded until they were all the way up here, right underneath me. I ended up shooting that doe at about 4 or 5 yards right here. And I'm only maybe 12 feet up in this tree, so she was right on top of me. She got right here to maybe 20 or 25 yards, and I had to draw then because I knew once she got up here coming right at me, I wasn't going to be able to draw. So I was at full draw for a long time. And then she came to about 8 or 9 yards right there and was facing towards me. I couldn't get a shot, so just had to wait. And kind of luckily that second doe winded me and spooked and took off. And this lead doe hopped right out here into my open lane and gave me a shot right there, probably 4 yards. So she's laying right over there about 60 yards away. Glad I got to see her go down. It was a pretty steep quarter and two shot, but shooting this heavy setup and being that close, I wasn't too worried about it. And as you see there, I got a full pass through, so it all worked out. And got some meat in the freezer. Let's go take a look at her. This is where that doe was standing and kicked up the leaves. You can see, pretty close shot. You can just barely see her down there. And it's always nice when you don't have to worry about following a blood trail. Watching them go down from the trees, obviously, plan A. There she is. A little bit smaller doe, but if I had to guess, I'd say probably last year's doe. You can see the entrance right there, where she was quartering to pretty hard. It's a pretty devastating cut though. Let's see where it came out at. Well, that's why there wasn't much of a blood trail. It's quartering so hard that it came out the, I can't tell, intestines or stomach, but has the hole plugged. I was wondering if that was the case, judging by the arrow and by how little blood I was finding, but a decent sized doe, and we'll get her out of here.